Okay, welcome ladies and gentlemen. You've joining us for round 15 of the Formula One League for 2020. It is our second last round of the season. And this round was pegged for a mystery circuit. And because we missed PORTIMAO, we're going to go back to PORTIMAO because it's such a beautiful circuit located in Portugal. It's going to be 66 laps tonight, with each lap being 4.699 kilometres. The current standings at the moment for the championship, with two rounds to go, as you can see, Scott Black on in the top of the ladder there, quite a commanding lead ahead of Thomas Foster, who's going to be with us tonight. Halil Caesar moving up a spot from last round, moves up into P3. Marty Porter in P4 on 134 points. Michael Tonellan's actually at the Bathurst Challenge Real Racing in the Radical, so he can't make it with us tonight. Jack Song racing with us from home. He's also streaming live on Facebook, and he's in P6 in the championship with 76 points. Scott Fitzsimons, myself, Shane Gilfeather, Adrian Sarkison, Jesse Richards rounding out the top 10. We're currently in a qualifier session at the moment, and we've got a couple of new guys. This is Travis Eastow. He'll be in the Williams 88 car, and he's showing quite good pace for his first race with us tonight. He's currently in P5, but actually no one's really posted a time at the moment because we are still just in the opening stages of the qualifier session for tonight's round, round 15. Quite a tricky circuit. There's a lot of, I won't say off-camber corners, but there's very awkward corners to control the car. A lot of high crests. So as you saw on the real coverage, the guys were saying that they're just looking at the sky and pointing the car in the same direction. Hopefully it's going to stay on the track. It's easy for these guys to actually spin the car, as we've seen during the practice session tonight. On screen is Halil Caesar at the moment. He's on pole position with a 1:14.323. And we're expecting Marty Porter to put himself up on pole anytime soon. He's showing very speedy pace during the practice session. We'll bring up the track map. Okay, so during the race tonight, we're just going to, as I'll be joining, we're just going to record it automatically so you can enjoy each driver for about 30 seconds. But I'll be commentating through the qualifying session. And there you see it, Marty Porter, 1:12.702. Excellent time. That's going to be hard to beat, as he's just put over a second and a half on Halil Caesar, his closest competitor. Scott Flax gets a close to time. He's playing at coy. Looks like now he's out on track, just getting some laps in before the end. And that's Jack Song for Racing Point Team. Currently in P4. Great job from him. Always improving each round. Always seeing himself closer to the front of the pack. So this is really good. He came and joined us. If you missed the stream on the last round at Imola, we had some in-car footage of him on screen. So make sure you check that out. See what he looks like in real as he was racing from our store last round, because he had technical issues with his car, so he came in to join us in race. That's Jack Song, currently in P4. Marty Porter, 1:12.7. Wow, that's an amazing time there for Marty Porter, definitely dominating the time sheets at the moment. Scott Flack just getting into P2, so it'll be Scott Flack and Marty Porter front row at the moment, but Scott Flack's coming in for a fresh set, so he'll get another couple of laps in with that set of tyres. Halil Caesar, Cooler Master Racing, he's driving for. He's trying to knuckle down and really concentrate on this round. He really wants to get a result on the podium. Had a great race last night at Phillip Island in the V8, so he had a win in the third race of the night, our longest race, and he did really well with a 10-second lead over the whole field. But tonight it's Formula One, so he's got to get himself acquainted back to the Formula One car. Just under 4 minutes to go now. Halil's coming up onto the main straight. Nice sweeping right-hand turn. Top speed down the main straight. Just to let you all know too, there's no DRS tonight because there is a glitch with the track. With the DRS, we've disallowed the use of the DRS for tonight, just to make it nice and even for everybody, as we do have a couple of new guys. Speaking of new guys, let's have a look at Thomas Cole. He's in the second Renault car of Daniel Ricciardo, and he's currently in P6 at the moment with a 116.096. You can see the front end just getting light there over the crest. Can't really take that flat. You've got to back it off, bring the weight of the car forward to keep the front end down. Otherwise, you won't get the car to turn in over the crest there. On the track map, we've got green sectors for P5. That's Jack Song at the moment. Travis Eastow, he's climbing up the timing sheets. And he's on a PB at the moment, so he could see himself up in the P3. Getting close to Hillel Caesar. He's got to improve over 1.2 seconds on this lap. So far, he's 0.6 up just on the first sector alone. We're in the second sector at the moment. It's coming over that blind right-hander crest down in the quarry. And coming round down on the main straight. So he's already made 1.3 seconds up. And this could be enough to get on P3. He's already on the second rail of the grid, but can he get on the left-hand side instead of the right-hand side? Here he comes, and he's just crossed the line, just behind Caesar. With a finish that one with a 114.544. A minute and a half to go. A couple of guys have parked it in the pits. There won't be enough time to change tyres and get out for another hot lap. As we see Hillel coming on the main straight on his outlap, coming down the main straight. Currently in P3 at the moment. Just have a look at his sector times there. Trying very hard to keep it on the track there. It's important not to overshoot these corners, because you're just going to burn up the fronts trying to get the car to turn in. While the car's going one direction at high speed, the track wants you to go the other direction. So the weight and load of the car's on the wrong side for the car to turn into most of these turns. You've got to really sacrifice speed in some corners just to make this corner, that double right hand up the hill there, where we're seeing Hillel go. That's definitely one you have to sacrifice the first corner to get the car pulled up in time to make the uphill run over the crest as Hillel is coming to finish his lap. It's not his fastest, he's already second off his own time, so that's not going to improve him with only 20 seconds left on the clock. As long as you've finished or you've crossed the line before the clock finishes, then your qualify lap will be allowed. So he does have time. Just scratching in for another hot lap. And he definitely got fastest third sector of that one, so he wants to keep going. Now that the tyres have really warmed up, that's the end of the quali session, but we've still got a couple of guys on flying laps at the moment. Actually, all but three guys are still out there. Just go to see how Travis Eastow's in the pits. Thomas Cole coming down. PB for him, that's 115.810. Although he lost a lot of time in the second sector there, he was a second and a half up on his first sector. The good time for him. He's just pipped Jack Song, so he'll move up in a P5. That'll get him still on the third row of the grid, but he'll be on the inside line for the main straight, so we'll see how he gets a good run there. Okay, so that's Thomas Cole finish his lap. He'll have that on track. So Hello Caesar coming across the line. That's the target 112. I think he had his lap disallowed because he didn't have any time showing up on the splits there. So at the end of that, it looks like Marty Porter's got fastest lap, which puts him on pole with a 112.702. Next to him will be Scott Black with a 113.072.31 off lead time. Second row will be Hillel Caesar and Travis Eastow in the Rocket Williams racing car. Good time from him. He's been improving his times as the night goes on. So through the race, we might see him climb up a bit further. Thomas Cole, third row of the grid in P5. He will start from on the inside line there. In the second of the Renaults, and Jack Song just getting pipped there towards the end, so he'll be on the third row of the grid as well in P6, and yours truly will start from P7. Okay, just going to see if the guys are ready to go. And then we'll get this race underway. I'm just typing because a couple of guys want to concentrate and don't need the distraction. So while we wait, we'll just set up the screen, make sure we've got all the info for you so you can keep an eye on what's going on. And we'll bring up the track map so we'll see where the guys are on screen. Okay, welcome back. The guys are all ready to go. So we're going to kick it over to the 66 lap race tonight. And we'll leave you with the viewing now. So wish us all luck.
Thank you. Oh. Oh!
And there you have it, guys. That was the race. Well done to Marty Porter. Excellent job from our newbie, Travis Eastdale. Let me just bring up the results so you can all see. Okay, so Marty Porter, P1, excellent job. Travis Eastdale, I think he got it done on pit stops, which is did really well to make him last that long. That's a good job from him. And third was Scott Flack. He tried hard to chase Travis, but spent all of his time and tyres battling with Marty Porter for about 70% of the race there. Hello, Caesar. Moved up into P4. Well done to him. He had a couple of incidents, but climbed back up to P4, which was a great job. Shane, myself, got stuck with a pit lane penalty. That was for speeding coming into pit lane. Thomas Cole finishes in P6. And Jack Song retired early. I think it was electrical issues. I'm not too sure. We'll have to interview him after the race for next week and let you guys know. So thanks for watching. And I'll just bring up the schedule for our next race. And it's the last one, unfortunately, for us. Pretty sad. It's on the 10th of December. And it'll be at Abu Dhabi, round 16. Make sure you join us then. And cheers for now. With thanks to our sponsors, Jewelry on James at Burley Heads, Racecentre is proud to announce that we'll be giving away this Supercars Limited Edition Pulsar watch to the winner of our 2020 V8 League season. The special watch features include chronograph function, stainless steel hard-coated case with black patterned leather strap and red stitching, date calendar and 100 meters water resistant. Once again, we'd like to thank our friends at Jewelry on James.